from this energy, from everybody that's going to be here all week. They need this, right? We all need it. I need it too. I need ideas. I want more ideas. I wanted to connect with you guys. The friends. Oh, that's really cool. Love the Friendsgiving idea. That's awesome. Yes, Friendsgiving. Awesome stuff. What else? Okay, so three of you have said about the Friendsgiving. Hi, Megan. Hi, Priscilla. There's, yeah, Robin. Yeah, you're right. The Friendsgiving idea. My, you know what? It's like, it's Thanksgiving. There's like so much going on. Any birthdays in December or November? Mine is coming up December 2nd. So it's like, ah, so much stuff, like so many cool ideas, all the things that we can do. And all of that, even though it may seem like, oh my God, there's so much. Pick a couple of things. You don't have to do everything because you're just going to go drive yourself crazy. Pick a couple of things that you're going to feel comfortable with, that if you have doubts about how to execute it, you can go back, watch the recording again, ask other people, ask the presenter. If you message any of the speakers on these trainings, you're going to get an answer. Everybody's so generous and so helpful that you're going to get any clarification that you need. Partnering with, yeah, joint parties. That's really good because you guys, we get to collaborate and you get to connect with that other direct salesperson network and she gets to connect with yours. So it's a win-win situation. That's pretty cool. Yeah, this week is awesome. I know. So we're about to kick it off. If you guys are ready, make sure that you guys share this with your teams. People forget. People are busy. People are thinking about what they're going to be eating with the turkey, right? People are already, not me. I probably think about the menu the day before. Typical Paula. But remind people right now. Remind them that this training is going on. Go out there. Remind them that this is happening. We're going to be here for the next hour. I'm going to take the first 20 minutes or so of your time. And then we'll have Robin and Erica who are also going to be sharing great content with you guys. So make sure you have some paper. I have something to share with you as well. My dear Erica is going to help us with that in a little bit. And because I don't want to distract you guys, but I want you to take something away with you because we won't talk a lot about it today. So excited to be here, you guys. My name is Paula Chavez. I'm a Zaya Elite. I joined Zaya in 2018, February 2022 is going to be 4 years. I'm in Orlando, Florida. Any Floridians here in the house? Where are you watching from? If you're in Florida, double high five to you. If you're not in Florida, one high five for you. Just kidding. Love you all. But hey, if you're in Florida, just, you know, we finally can wear leggings without dying, right? Like we can go out in leggings. So my point with that is, you guys, we gotta be wearing our clothes all the time. And I'm gonna be talking about, so here's the thing, talking to strangers, right? And it's like, what does that mean? Like, it's not like you're gonna go talk to somebody on the street and like, hey, do you like leggings? You can. Some people do it. I've done it. I've knocked on doors. I've done all those things. But it's, I personally didn't want to call it cold messaging or cold prospecting, but that's the reality. It is, how do we talk to people that we're not familiar with, to people that we don't have a relationship with, right? Many of us start this business without really having a lot of following or credibility. We're not these big influencers. We're like, maybe some of you are, you know, you've been more of a scroller. You scroll on social media, but you've never really posted anything. You haven't connected with anybody. And now all of a sudden you have a business and you're like, who do I talk to? Right? So this is what I'm hoping helps you have a communication, have these conversations with people, because you can't just sit here and wait for people to come to you. It's kind of like waiting to posting and praying and hoping that something happens, right? Like it is intimidating and it's a little bit scary, but I hope that after this training, you guys feel more comfortable that, dude, you're not doing anything wrong. Like you are bringing this opportunity, these products, this community, something exciting for people to do, because you know what? There's so much going crazy out there right now that a lot of people need this in their lives. You may think that you're bothering people, but you're not. You have no idea how many lives have changed because of Saya. And I have a feeling that you are one of those lives. Yes or no? At least the day that I hit the submit for the starter kit, when I submit my rep enrollment back in 2018, I didn't want to get up from my bed. Like, I was overwhelmed. I was tired of working so hard, doing all these things. I was teaching, I was coaching. I was a mom of three, driving around. And my kids would ask me for ice cream on a Friday after school, and I had to tell them no. Like, I just wanted to go to sleep. I felt like the bills were piling up. Our debt was growing. I remember one of those days, a few weeks before, one of the cars needed all the wheels to be replaced. We didn't have the money for that. Some weeks we didn't have money to put gas in the car. So Zaya gave me hope again. So the day I submitted the enrollment, I felt empowered again. Like, I felt like, man, I can do something with this. And I was excited about it. So imagine somebody in your circle of people, somebody that you haven't even met yet, is feeling the way that Paula was feeling then. And you could be that angel that helps them. I can't explain it any other way. Like, there's no secret script, and I will give you some ideas of messages. There's no secret sauce or the best conversation, or there's no perfect picture or perfect leg. Like, there's nothing. It's finding the right season, right? Like, that person, your job when you're presenting the opportunity to somebody, you're intercepting them wherever they're at. Some of them, you may find this is not the season for them. So what you're going to get, that's going to be this sheet that you guys can print out. It's how to follow up, because majority of people, especially people that you don't know, they're not ready to say yes to you. They're not ready. They're not ready. They're like, wait a second. I'm here writing my list of things that I need to do tomorrow. And now you're telling me that I can start a business. Like, I don't have time for this stuff. You know what I mean? Like, you're planting the seed. And I always say this, the day you plant the seed is not the day you eat the fruit. The day we plant the seed is not the day we eat the fruit. We got to water it. We got to nurture it. I kill all my plants. So I don't know. I'm not a great example of this, but you have to water the plant, right? Like, does it need to be outside? Does it need to be inside, right? Like, all these things that seed needs to become a plant, to give fruit. The same way, you have to start building those relationships. But you may get somebody, you're at the store and somebody says, oh my God, I love your leggings. And how many of you, I do this all the time. Sometimes I get like, oh, I don't know what to say. Somebody says, oh my God, I love your leggings. And you're like, thank you. And you run away. No, we can't do that. Okay. It's potentially an opportunity to say, thank you. Actually, I sell this. I would love to send you more information. Collect their information. So here's the thing. Always be ready with business cards. But when somebody approaches you like that, what you really want to do is get their information. Pretend that you don't have business cards. Collect their information. Because that person is really not going to, it's not going to remember to message you. They'll probably lose the business card. Assume that they have a toddler. They put it in the back of their pocket, put it in the laundry. They were dying to reach out to you, but the darn business card went in the washer and now they don't know how to find you. But if you ask them, how can I reach out to you? What's the best way to contact you? I'd love to send you more information about these leggings. Now you have a way to communicate with them. The less you say in the moment, the better. Okay, so get a phone number, get an email, get something. You give your business card decreases the chances of you being able to have a second conversation with that person. Okay, maybe add them to your Facebook group right away. Maybe invite them to follow you on Instagram. But say, do you have your phone? Here, let me help you. And you type their contact information and send a message to yourself. Something like that. Like, find a way to, I'm going to try not to read the chat right now, you guys, but I'll keep an eye on it. But those are great ideas. Yeah, but ultimately, it's not about the lead, it's what we do with the lead. So always think about that. Let me check my notes here. So I want you guys to think about recruiting, because I can give you secret scripts and secret scripts, which really don't exist. There's no secret script. Recruiting is confidence. If you're not confident about what we have, if you're not confident about the product, if you're not wearing the product, if you're not excited every Wednesday, if you don't feel excited about new releases, if you don't feel excited about how a person feels when they put on these leggings, when they put on these clothes, you're gonna have a hard time talking about it. So build that belief. And in the beginning, just read the room. See, like, why are people so excited about this? Why? Look at the pictures, read the testimonials of people in the Zion Marketing Group if you're in there. See how people are so excited about the outfits. Watch the Zaya Active Instagram page, the stories. Look at all those pictures that they reshare. It's so cool to see, like, the little kids, like the older people, like how everybody's so excited wearing Zaya. Use those not only to share them, but to build belief yourself, because no matter how many pictures you share, but if you don't believe that you have something great here in your hands, it's gonna be hard, especially for those of you that are newer. If you join, but you haven't built that credibility yet. You haven't built, right, like, success. Maybe you haven't earned your first paycheck. Because the minute you earn your first paycheck, holy moly, the belief goes through the roof. Because now that's kind of like what validates that you're right, like you're moving the needle forward. It doesn't mean that if you're not earning anything that it's not working, but it definitely changes the game when you earn that first paycheck. Yes or no? Right? Like that first paycheck is like, oh, snap. Yeah. I want to keep earning. So imagine when you're sharing the opportunity with somebody else, you're passing on that hope that one day they also are going to start earning a paycheck, or they're going to get, you know, thank you messages from customers telling them, oh my God, I love these pants. I love this. I feel so good. I went to the gym. I started working out again. I love this thing. I want more, blah, 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 blah. I want to host a party. I want more of that free stuff. Are you kidding me? I can get free stuff. Yes. Heck yes. So it's building that belief, and it's with activity and confidence. Take care of yourself. And by that, I mean, what can you do to build your confidence? Where's Zaya? Work out. Focus on your well-being. Focus on that. When we are as individuals, when we are in a good place, when we feel joy, when we feel content about ourselves, we want to do more. Zaya helps, because we put on those pants and it's like a boost of confidence that helps us take pictures, share. You're building that platform so that when you find a stranger, now we're talking social media, you're sharing pictures, you're posting in stories, you find somebody on social media. I'll give you guys an example. So I go on Instagram and I see this lady, she's in her 50s. I have her here. I'm like, she's going to be on my team. I am so determined to have her on my team. She's awesome. She's got a small following. So pay attention to this example. I don't know if I'm talking too fast, too slow. I'm sorry, but we still have time. So I've been following her Instagram account and I see that she posts outfits. She doesn't have any links, but she shares like these new shoes and blah, blah, blah. And she's like, oh, you can wear this jacket and that. So I message her after just dropping a few likes and this and watching her stories, just getting noticed, right? Like I'm just planting the seed. Now I'm watering it and I'm complimenting her and I'm edifying her and I'm watching what she's doing. And I message her a couple of days ago, yesterday morning, I message her and I'm like, hey, do you get paid like a lot for all the stuff that you share? Like, just like if I had her in front of me. And she said, no, actually I started this account recently. I'm like, oh really? What motivated you to start this account? And she said, well, my friends were always telling me that I'm so stylish. So I really want to help people put together clothes and look good. I'm like, bingo. I'm like, oh my gosh. So you're doing basically what I do. I'm a rep for an activewear company. We also have different styles. Like we have pants and clothes that you can wear here and there. And I sent her some pictures of different outfits. I am marketing group. And I said, you're basically doing what I do and you can get paid for doing what you're doing. So she said she works part-time here. She does. I'm like, so we're having this conversation. I send her this Zaya video and I'm following up with her. Right, like I'm following up with her. She said she was gonna watch her video over the weekend when she's home. And so, you know, I'm like, just watch the video right now. But anyway, so I'm gonna give you guys this follow-up sheet is gonna help you because this is how to follow up. So I haven't heard back from her. So when I message her, I'm gonna use my 24, and you'll see it there, my 24, 48-hour follow-up, which says, what did you like best from what you saw in the video? The video that I said is the opportunity video that is in the join section of all of our shopping websites. When you go to join, there's a short video. It's about 5 minutes. So when I ask, so this is what I ask people. I have this for you guys right here. I say, have you heard of Zaya? This is the first thing I asked this lady. I said, before I said, do this, do that. I said, have you heard of Zaya? And she said, no, I have no idea what that is. I'm like, okay. Majority of people out there have not heard about Zaya. We think, oh my God, there's so many people. There's so many people that have no clue that Zaya exists. They have no idea. Hi, everybody. So that's what I say. Have you heard of Zaya? No. Another question that I ask, have you ever thought about becoming a rep? And this is something that applies to people in parties. Right. In when you're running your Facebook parties, when you're doing parties on Instagram or whatever, you're in a platform where there's strangers. You ask the question, have you ever considered doing what I do? Have you ever considered becoming a rep? I'm a rep for an activewear company. This is what I do. The people that are in a party, you can post, but I would highly suggest you reach out to people individually and say, hey, I'm not sure if this is for you. I know we're talking about all the products and this and that. I posted about the business opportunity. I just wanted to reach out to you and see if maybe it's something that you would like more information on, right? Like that direct message, because posting and praying is not the best formula, you guys. So are you open to taking a look into the business opportunity? Are you open to taking a look at the rep opportunity? Like you can word it different any way you want, but basically ask if they're open. So when I'm out there prospecting and sending a message to somebody that I don't know, this is like a little formula that I try to follow in my head. I compliment them. I compliment, right? I'm like, oh my God, I love your workout videos. I love your pictures. I love what you're doing on your account. I love that you do this. I love your recipes. I love that, what, like, right? All of that. I love how much you participate in my VIP group. Maybe it's somebody that you've never talked to, but they're in your VIP group. Thank you so much for being so active in the group. You're awesome. Hey, have you ever thought about becoming a rep? Hey, have you ever heard of Zaya? Hey, does that make sense? You guys, it's like if you were talking to this person in person, but what's cool is that it's, you're here, you're sitting behind the scenes, you're sitting behind the screen. It's a little less intimidating, especially if it's a stranger. It's not like they're gonna come find you. Like, don't be scared. Don't be scared. I'll tell you what. A lot of the leaders in the company were invited to learn about Zaya from a cold message. Did you guys know that? So don't be scared. Your next rock star may be out there waiting for you to reach out. Do you know on Instagram, think about influencers, all these people that are posting outfits and right, like they're trying to make a little bit of commission off of an Amazon link, off of a Old Navy link, Fabletics link, like all these people, they're trying to make income online. All the money right now is being spent online. We have an online business. Don't be afraid to offer a way for people to, number one, spend their money online, they're going to spend it anyway. Number two, make money online. That's where it's at right now. So you guys, I'm almost done here. So in conclusion, when you're reaching out to people, be postured, like get excited. Something that works, maybe put on some music, get on set 15, 20 minutes a day where you reach out and get into conversations with people. And once you feel comfortable with, like, you know what, I'm just going to ask this person, hey, have you ever thought of joining Zaya? Hey, have you ever thought about a way to make money with your social media? I see what you're doing. I see that you're pretty active. You help people so much. This would be a great way to serve your community. That's a great message for influencers. Hey, you provide so much value on your social media. I have something that may be of interest to you. Have you ever considered adding another stream of income? Let me tell you a little bit more about what I do. Simply ask the question, you guys. But all these recruiting, these prospecting, all these asking the question starts with your own level of belief and your own confidence. So put on a little makeup, put on some music, shake those shoulders, do some jumping jacks, put your energy up and reach out to people. Reach out to people. Don't be afraid. Don't feel scared about sharing this opportunity because it's going to change your life. If you help other people change their life or at least get started, they'll take care of the rest. You're going to change your life too. My life has completely changed because of Zaya. And I know that our next speaker has also been super blessed by Zaya. Robin, you go next. Thank you so much, you guys, for being here. Keep sharing this and let's go. I'm going to be quiet now.
Thank you, Paula. Can you guys hear me? Awesome. Thank you so much, Paula. A lot of what I have to say is going to piggyback right off of that. I have 15 or 20 minutes, you guys, to get you fired up and change your verbiage from I suck at recruiting to recruiting is my jam. So I Googled all things recruiting. Know your why, know where to recruit, how to recruit, 5 best tips to improve your recruiting in direct marketing. Good stuff, but textbook stuff. I want to keep this real and I want to hopefully give you something to walk away with tonight. So my daughter just turned 13 last week and she also started her basketball junior high season last week. I love her dearly, but she has what I like to call, I want to be the best without practice syndrome. The first time she picked up a basketball since last basketball season was the first practice of this basketball season. She's not going to be the best. She is going to need to practice and she's going to need to be consistent when she hops on that court on December 7th for her first game. You guys, team building is the same way. If you can make an automatic part of your business like partying and selling leggings, it will just get easier and easier. And it will ignite your business and light a fire inside of you. Because helping others achieve their goal in this business is like the greatest thing ever. The stage is set. So if you are partying, your audience or your market is right there in front of you, literally watching you do your thing. But so often, you guys, we get so caught up in the posts and the giveaways and the thank yous and the to-dos and the party that we actually forget to share the opportunity. And I'm not just talking about that one post on day 4 where you share the opportunity. No, it needs to be more than that. In your introductory live, for example, you know, pop on and say how all the gear that you're going to share this week is actually gear that you have gotten for free and half price. And you actually are clothing your family in this gear as well. And it's a great thing. You love your job. Share in that introductory live how, although it may seem like you are tied to Facebook all week and you have no life, that actually you do have a life and you use a third-party scheduling service. Don't be afraid to share that. Share that in your parties. Let them know that you are working full-time yet running this side business and you're very successful at it. When sharing our amazing joggers, mention how the cozy joggers are in our current starter kit. You see how you're just sprinkling it throughout the party. Grab those 5 to 6 pieces in our starter kit, even if you don't have the right pattern or the right color, it doesn't matter. And share those pieces, highlight them in a live. And then at the end, surprise them by saying, these are all the pieces in our current starter kit. And above all else, offer the opportunity to every single hostess. You guys, it's our obligation to do so. I always look at it as your hostess is shopping and she can pick this, this, or this, or she can grab the starter kit over here. And if she doesn't know that this is an option, that's not fair. You have to let her know that that is an option. So put those things into practice, you guys, if you are not already, until it becomes automatic and natural. They say people need to hear something 8 to 9 times before they say yes. So why not start saying that verbiage, talking about joining in the party while you have their attention? Okay, so you may be thinking, well, that's all great, Robin. I can do that. I can talk about the opportunity in my parties. I can post about it, but how do I get them to join me? And this is exactly what Paula was saying. You have to ask. You have to ask. I once heard that the more you go fishing, the more fish you will catch. Astounding, right? The top recruiters and team builders in Zaya, you guys, they are at the top because they have invited a whole heck of a lot of people to join them in this business. But guess what? They've also heard a whole heck of a lot of no's. A lot of people have told them no. Zaya isn't. The opportunity isn't for everyone, but we are never going to know if we don't ask, and they can't say yes if we don't ask. So we just have to get out there and ask. Fall in love with the process of sharing the opportunity and then detach yourself from the outcome. I'm going to read that again. Fall in love with the process of sharing the opportunity, but then detach yourself from the outcome. Your job is to share this awesome gig, right? But you in the end, it's not up to you whether they think that this is the best thing for them and for their family. That's got to be their decision. And it's not anything that you did or anything that you said, it's their choice in the end. So you've heard it before, 90% of, I believe, and if I'm wrong, somebody correct me, but I believe it's 90% of our current reps were first customers, then hostesses, who then became reps. You guys, it's beautiful. It works. It's proven, right? It's why we party. Everything happens in the party, and that's where the magic is. But I also believe in cutting to the chase. It doesn't have to be a set process of first this, then that, okay? She doesn't have to own the entire line first, then host a party 3 months later, and then join. What do you hear all the time in Zaya? Or what have you said time and time again? I wish I would have joined earlier. Right? We hear that all the time. My biggest regret is not saying yes sooner. So if a guest in a party is showing you interest and asking tons of questions, I will straight up message her and say, hey, you should rep Zaya with me. It's so much fun. Get the conversation started. This is 100% how I have asked. And if any of my level ones are on here, they can comment. This is how I have asked every single person on my team to join me. I simply started the conversation and asked, have you thought about repping Zaya? Or said, you should totally do this with me. You're opening up that door and you're inviting them in. You guys, a lot of people don't think that they're the right size, the right age, the perfect this, the perfect that to join our company. And so they're not going to come to us and say, hey, I want to join. They're not confident enough to do so. So we have to invite them. And then 9 times out of 10, they're going to say, heck yes, let's do this. How do I sign up? No, just kidding. That it happens, but it does not happen very often. More than likely, she's going to give you an obstacle of some sort. She's going to give you an obstacle, or he's going to give you an obstacle why they don't think that they can be a rep. You've heard them. You could probably chat them up on the side. Like, I could never sell. I'm not a salesperson. I'm too busy. I don't think I'd have enough time. I don't know of enough people. I don't do social media very well. I don't have the funds to get started, right? Those are the obstacles that they give us. And in my previous direct sales business, you guys, for 7.5 years, I would say, okay, thanks for getting back to me. And I would end it. And that is why I did not find a ton of success in my previous direct sales business. But 2 years ago, I listened to Blair Sells, and it was a training series just like this. And she talks about helping them overcome their obstacles. It is our job to help them see that they can rep this line, help them see that they have a place here in Zaya. It was seriously a game changer for me. It totally shifted my business. And it's a reason why I have in turn become a strong team builder. I have fallen in love with helping potential reps work past their I can't do it because, and helping them see that yes, they can. You guys, this is huge. So when they give me their obstacle, I will, let me take a drink, I'm super thirsty. Sorry about that. Yes, dig for the objections and offer a solution. So true, because if they don't give you a reason why, try to get to that reason why so that you can help them. So back to voice messenger. When she comes back and says, I could never sell, I'm not a salesperson, that is definitely 100% where I use voice messenger. So she can hear my voice, so she can hear my heart. And it just goes through so much better, in my opinion. So for example, I could never sell, I'm not a salesperson. I would respond, oh my gosh, Sarah, neither am I. I have found that sharing Zaya is just like sharing your favorite coffee drink or recipe with your girlfriends. You love it and you want everyone else to love it just as much. So you share it. Plus added bonus, your Zaya wardrobe will grow quickly and you'll have a space to share it. It's so much fun. It's going to be more natural than that, you guys. And when you use Voice Messenger, you can delete it. You don't have to send it. So if it doesn't sound right, if you're shaken and if it's not coming across clearly, you can get rid of it and redo it. Let's do another one real quick. When she comes back and says, I could never do what you do. That's typically when I'll talk about how streamlined our business model is, how we have no catalogs, no order forms, no changing specials, that you can fit this into the nooks and crannies of your day, truly, honestly. And I'll talk about how these lives I do and these selfies I take, I didn't do that stuff before Zaya. This is something that I have grown into, and she will see that once she jumps on board too, she's going to find a community of people that started just like she did, and she's absolutely going to fall in love. So all that verbiage about commissions and compensation plan and website fee and starter kit price, all of that, personally, I don't share any of that until she's really interested and she's asking the questions. It can be overwhelming in my opinion. So I keep that in the vault until she's ready for that type of information. You're just going to be laser focused on hearing her and helping her through those doubts and insecurities, because that's the real stuff. Those things are real. And those are the things keeping people from joining this business. They're the things that are keeping you from asking people to join this business. It's so much of all of this. So you guys, I still miss the mark sometimes. Maybe Rachel's on here with me, but I messaged a great customer in July and just said, have you ever thought about repping Zaya? Because she's a great customer. I know she loves it and she shares her pictures on my page. Her response was simply, no, I haven't thought about it. And I don't know if I was busy that day or what was going on, but I said, okay, thanks for getting back to me. I resorted back to my old practices for whatever reason. And then a couple months later, she made another purchase. And I went back to that message and I'm like, oh my gosh, that was not a no. So I used Voice Messenger and I shared my thoughts with her. And I'm like, you should totally join me. I think you would be great. You guys, she signed on. I was on my way to Summit. And she messaged me and she said, I want to jump on board. And now she's probably going to hit director this month. So she's a complete rock star. But I think there's some of you hopefully on here that are thinking, oh my gosh, I need to go back to Messenger. Go back to those people who didn't flat out say, heck no, I hate direct sales. I don't want to join you. Okay. Those people who gave you those obstacles or objections, go find them. Go back to them. You have every reason and right to go back and message them and invite them to join us. Again, don't miss the mark like I did so many times in the past. Okay, so what if they don't respond at all? Dun, 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 like that's the question, right? The big one. I messaged her about the opportunity, but she never responded. You have to follow up, like Paula said. Look at it this way. You send her a message and she reads it. She's possibly interested. She's mulling it over. But she also is probably thinking, Robin probably messaged 50 people in her contacts today. She's probably just scrolling through and asking everybody the same thing. It's like, I always use this analogy. It's kind of like a boyfriend who shows interest in you and you play a little hard to get, and then he never comes back. He never asks you out again. So it's like, well, I guess he wasn't that interested in me. If he was, he would have tried a little harder. Your prospects probably feel the same way. Follow up with her, like let her know, like, no, seriously, I want you on my team. I think you would be awesome. So it's super, super, super important to follow up. And I have some crazy stories where reps messaged potential reps for years. Megan Bating has a phenomenal story. 7-8 times over the course of 2 years with zero response. And finally, this girl recently joined her and she's going to do amazing things. So sometimes they just, I don't know, they're just thinking about it. They need the time, but definitely follow up because that tells them, no, I'm serious about you. So make sure, this is super important. Make sure it does not stop with the ding, you have a new enrollment. You guys, invest your time and energy into helping your new reps find their way and find success in this business. Continue to help her overcome those insecurities. Find a system that works and see it through. Be really intentional about why you want to build a team, why you are adding teammates. Please, please do not just add teammates to add teammates. Because when we build successfully, we get more and more excited about it. And then we want to do it again, and we want to do it again, and we want to do it again, knowing that we are truly impacting lives. It's like the best part about this business. And if you haven't experienced it yet, or if you joined Zaya and you said, nope, I don't want to grow a team, maybe shift that. And it's okay to change. It's okay to change your course. Okay, in conclusion, and so we're going to have a little bit of extra time, which I think is totally cool. But in conclusion, I want to leave you with my 4 main bullet points tonight. Make it a consistent practice to share the opportunity. Make it a part of your daily routine, just like selling leggings, just like posting. Make it a part of all of that. 2, ask. Just simply ask. We are a part of an amazing company that is going to continue to soar. It's not a bad thing to invite her in. It's not a bad thing to invite him in. 3, help her or him overcome those objections. So key. Total game changer in my business. Start doing that if you're not already. And then 4, once he or she enrolls, invest in your new rep. So that is all I have. You guys go start 10 conversations tonight. 10 conversations, because I guarantee you something will come out of that. And if you need help after she responds and she gives you her obstacle, reach out to your sponsor, reach out to me, reach out to anybody and say, okay, now what do I say back to her? Until you find the confidence yourself, reach out, ask people to help you. Okay, I'm super excited to now turn it over to Erica Harold. She is going to be talking about multi-host parties, which I love. And I'm so excited to learn more tips and tricks for that line, that part of my business. So Erica, you're up.
Thanks, Robin. You guys hear me okay? Thumbs up from Robin or Paula. Okay, perfect. Perfect. Okay. I'm so excited and I see so many of my beautiful teammates on, and this is one of my favorite topics is parties, because it is the lifeblood of our business. We cannot recruit. We cannot rank advance if we don't do parties and sell and represent this activewear. So I truly believe in at every level, whether you're a rep or you are a Zaya presidential or you are whatever rank you are, like you have to be doing parties. It just is what it is. And they are amazing. I have a true love for parties. And I tell everybody, if you don't find a way, fall in love with them. So a couple years ago, actually, I started doing mega host parties. And at first, I kind of got this weird feeling. If you guys are doing mega host parties right now, maybe you're doing multi-host, maybe you're doing battle of the hosts, whatever you want to call it. There's so many names out there, and I think we get confused on what it is, but basically it's multiple hosts in one party. Let's just cut that. If you are doing that already, tell us that you're doing it in the comments. I would love to know who's already doing it. But when I first started, there was like this weird feeling. I had heard of some other ladies on my team doing it, and I was like, oh God. And I was so nervous, and I was thinking, oh no, like, well, what about this? What about that? Well, what about this? And what if it gets confusing? And then I was like, Erica, shut up. Just do it. And guess what? I asked them for zero advice. I got zero tips, zero training, because that's what leaders do. They don't get any tips or any training. They just go. And I thought, okay, I'm just going to make this stupid simple. Like, I'm just going to do it. And it's the same as a single party with one host. I just have like five of them in there, or two or 10 or whatever you want to do. And guess what? If one of them's a bust, it's no sweat off my back. I'm not worried about it because there's other women in there, right? So I want to just back up a second and say, if you are doing parties right now and they are going well, don't change anything. You do not have to change anything. This is a way to do parties, but it is not the only way. Take bits and pieces. You can implement some of the things. I'm actually going to screen share. Hopefully it works. I don't know. And show you one of my most recent parties, because I do all of mine this way. I do one mega party a month and I'm done. I'm like in and out, right? You guys, my one rule on corporate calls is to not cuss and not make any sexual innuendo. So I'm working really hard on those two things. Because this is life, you guys. I'm a real person. I'm sitting at my kitchen table. My husband and I were drinking a beer together. We may be top leaders in the company, but we're real, right? We're so real. And I think as you guys watch all night, you're going to look at this and be like, oh, but I'm not Paula. Or, oh, I'm not Robin. Or, oh, I'm not Natalie Robinson. No, you're not. You're you, girlfriend. And that is your power. That is your power. So when you're thinking about these mega parties, there's no one way to run parties. There's no right way and there's no wrong way. You need to have fun and you need to be you, because people are going to be attracted to you, and you want those people to be your customers and to be on your team. If they don't like you, you want them to move on, right? And bless and release. So one reason I really love mega parties is it takes the pressure off of any one host. So I hear a lot of objections. Oh, I don't have any friends that are going to buy. Oh. Well, guess what? You're in a party with like four or five other hosts. So no one's going to know. Do you guys watch that TikTok? It's like, nobody's going to know. No one's going to know. That's literally how it is. Nobody's going to know. So what I do every month is I have a theme. It's really easy, you guys. Like, dang near every month, our seasons change. Things change, right? We have different holidays. So come up with a theme of the month. And I'm going to show you guys my theme for November and the party that I did. Because it's super easy. And then when you're talking about booking parties with people, you can utilize that theme as a way to intrigue them and get them in, right? Because if you're like, hey, do you want to have a Zaya party? They're like, oh my God, not another party. But if you identify it in a different way that sounds fun, and it's like a fall fashion show, that's my most recent one. They're like, hell yeah, dang it. I already ruined it, you guys. They're like, yes, like a fall fashion show. Yeah. I want to do that. That I want to do. I'm ignoring the chat because I can't multitask. Okay. So the one and only time I'm going to support Nike other than buying their shoes is with their slogan, and it's just do it. So if you've been thinking about mega host partying, but you have not done it yet, get out of your own way and just do it. It is so, so simple. I literally had to rake my team over the coals with ideas for this training, because I'm like, I could give a mega host party in 5 minutes. You literally take a single party and you do two adjustments. And this is what I do. First adjustment I make, I'm going to my notes because I was trying to stay on track, you guys, because I can talk like for 5 hours about anything, is I make an intro post. And I'm going to show you guys what that looks like. And it, I tag every host and I put their personal shopping link. That's the one biggest objection I get from my team on mega parties. They're like, oh my gosh, but like, how do they know who's what host to buy from? You guys, they know who they were invited by. It's very rare that you're going to find a lot of customers in the same party that know all of the other hosts, right? And if you do, then do a better job as the rep, making sure that you're kind of switching up hosts and when you're having all of that, okay? So I've never had any issues with somebody ordering on the wrong link. I've never had anything like that. It's always been super simple. And if you've done mega host parties, you probably feel like at least 90% of the time it goes pretty smooth, right? As long as you did your job as the rep and made it clear what host to order from. The second thing I do is I tell the host that they are going to be in a multi-host party. But I don't say, hey, you're going to be in a multi-host party, because that's our inner language. We don't say that. Okay. I say things like, hey, there's going to be five other ladies in there with you who are all going to be snagging free and half off gear and be helping with commenting and the participation. It's going to be super fun. And I have some language. I should have copied and pasted that before to put in the chat. I'm going to do that. Okay. So those are the only two different things that I do. But the party posts are exactly the same. However, if you want in the Zaya Marketing's design group that's like Zaya wide, there are mega party posts all over in there you can use if you want to get like really good at all of those things. But I just think keep it simple. Run it just like you would a party. You want to show our leggings. You want to show our tanks. You want to show our bras. You guys, that's what people are here for. They don't need to know that there's, you know, how many hosts are in here and all of that. Another thing I do is I do like a little fun engagement thing. Like, hey, tag the person who invited you here and say something that you love about them, right? And then a lot of other people have asked me like, well, what do you do when you follow up with the guest at the end of the party? Because if you are not following up with every guest in the party, you are missing out on thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars. Every time I have a party, I message every single person until Facebook puts me in jail. I'm like, bring it on, Facebook. Like, I'm coming for you. Put me in jail, baby. Give me that little red exclamation point, right? For sending too many messages. And if you have not gotten that, I challenge you to get that in your business, because it is, that means you have arrived. So I message every single person. I thank them for being a part of the party. And I use the host name that invited them. So if you go to your members, let me just see if I can just do a cute little screen share. Share screen. Okay. So here is my most recent party. Can you guys see that? Paula, can you see that before I took it back to this one? Okay. Okay. Now, hopefully people don't start blowing up my chat. This is my party. Okay. So it's called Stuff Your Closet Zaya Style, right? Because you guys, it's November and everybody's gonna be stuffing a bird here next week. So let's just do that. So here's my announcement post. Let's see if we can click on this bad boy. So look at this. This is what I do. So shop here with your host, and everybody's link who is in there is there. Okay. Super simple, you guys. This is like, it's the game changer of it. Now, how do I get back? And then, so if you go to your group members, you just click on all these cute little faces, just click, get out of there. If you go down to the members, so when you go to message all of your people, I just hit see all these bad boys, and it's going to tell you who they were invited by. So when you go to message these people, you can say, thank you for joining Rachel's Zaya party. Thank you for joining Patty's Zaya party. You want to make that a little bit more, personable, because maybe, just maybe, they have not seen, get out of here. They have not seen the party. Okay. Just because they're in it does not mean they have seen a single post, because Facebook is a love-hate relationship. See, there's 60 people seen by 13. Wah, wah, wah. One person liked it. Okay. This also had like what, five hosts. And I think we did like $4,000 in sales. Okay. So just because it's only seen by certain people does not mean, and I'm scrolling down just to kind of show you guys like a little insight, because I don't think that we do this enough. I do thank yous for every order. So do you want to know where 90% of my orders came from? Me personally messaging them. Okay. it came from my personal messages and upselling every order when they say, oh, I saw the light and tight leggings. I really would love something that sucks my tummy in. Great. Girlfriend, you need to pair those with a bomber bra and you're going to feel like a million freaking bucks. So I want to challenge you to make sure that you are utilizing that, especially in mega parties and having the opportunity to connect it with that host. Get that little red exclamation mark. I pray that you do. So here is the language. I just kind of typed this out fast before this call that I send when I'm trying to book a party. So a lot of people go, do you have a graphic for a mega party? No, it's a party. It's just a party. So use your party graphic. Use your party language. But here is, okay, Paula's laughing, but I think that you get it because you get these same objections, don't you? Like you guys, it's just a party. It's just a party. It just has like five hosts. I do think that there is battle of the hosts is great. That's two people. But I do think a sweet spot for these mega host parties that I have found is like five to six hosts. I've done one with 11. I've done one with 9. Like that kind of gets up into like an area that I don't really like to explore all at once. However, if you have that time commitment and you can manage that many hosts and personalities and people, that's great. I always say that you can always anticipate for every five parties you book for one to blow you off and like completely ghost you. One is going to be like a 200 or dud or get one order. Okay. So you're looking at out of those five parties that you book, three to be really good. So when you're grouping them into a multi-host party, look at how much time you're saving, girlfriend. Like you would have just wasted so much time on those other two parties. Like I can't even imagine. Time is money. What is your, I can't get into that. I'm not going to go on your hourly rate. Anyways, here's my language. I don't know what you guys are saying in the chat, but I bet it's pretty witty. If my team's here, they're probably being crazy. Okay. Drop any questions you have. And then Robin, I might just ask you if there's any questions so I don't have to scroll back through. Let me see if there's any other, I think the only other thing, how to coach your host. So this is huge, you guys. If you are not coaching your host on a daily basis, you're missing the mark. I recently was a part of a party where I hosted like a health and wellness party. And she messaged me the day before the party got set up and said, hey, invite your friends, here's the link. Literally like that. And I'm like, cool. What else do I got to do? Like, what are the host rewards? Like, what do you want from me? I had no idea. Right. And I do parties all the time, but I don't know how to host a party for somebody else. I'm a killer rep hosting parties, but I don't know how to host them. She gave me zero coaching. Didn't talk to me. Anytime somebody ordered, did not talk to me. Anytime I posted, did not message me personally and say, thank you for your post. I love that. I made videos in my party. I did all this thing because I know what it's like to have a good host. So I was like, I'm gonna be a good host. You guys, I got zero coaching. You know what I learned? We need to be baller coaches to our hosts. So here's the tricker. Okay. When you're doing multi-hosts, you can link them all in one chat. Okay. Some people don't like that. Some people love it. I have mixed feelings. I like it. And sometimes depends on the host. And sometimes I don't like it. Here's what I do. When I link them all in one chat, I tell them before I do it. And then I only give daily tips and tricks that apply to all of them every day. So I'll say on day one, hey, can you put a welcome post out there with a photo of you and Zaya? Or if you don't own any Zaya or want to take a photo, here's like a graphic and I post like 10 graphics or whatever. Okay. And then every day I will give them a couple tips and tricks, that I'm asking them to do. Do they do them all? Hell no. If they did, they would have $1,000 parties every time, but they don't. Okay. So here's the deal. All your job is to give them the tools and resources and guidance. That's it. It's not your job to make sure that they do anything. You are not their mother. Okay. You're not responsible for the outcome. So I have them all in one chat. However, I communicate with them individually on helping them with their specific customers, celebrating every single order. I don't care if it was a bomber bra, a pair of socks, or if it was a $500 order. I'm like, girlfriend, you got your first order. Or yeah, we're at the $200 level. Woohoo! Right? I am like their biggest cheerleader because they feel like it's so exciting. So I do that independently with them. So if all of the speakers here were in a chat, I would be coaching them daily together. And then I'd be messaging Paula, yo, girl, you just got an order from Robin. Like, she just dagged herself a pair of lighting tights. And then I go into the party and I thank her and I tag that host. And then that host hopefully will go and comment and thank their person, but they don't always, because people are people. Okay. So that is a super big game changer, in my opinion, is to make sure that you're doing those two things and coaching on a daily basis. And I learned this through being a host in a party for health and wellness, and I got zero coaching. So don't expect that they know anything about Facebook and how it works or the algorithms. I actually train my hosts on algorithms, and I tell them, if you don't comment on stuff, no one's going to see this, because this is how Facebook works. And I do it in a voice memo, and I'm very nice. I'm being really raw with you guys, but like with my host, I'm like, hey girlfriend, Facebook's kind of a beezy, so let's talk about her. And let's just like, let's work this together. So teach those hosts those things. Tell them what to post. You can literally write out a message. I will write out a message for them to send to their people. I'll do whatever it takes as long as they're willing to send the message and do the work. Okay. That is about it. Is there questions?
Somebody asked, how do you make sure they see their messages if you're messaging their guests?
Oh, woof. I used to go and friend everybody. And sometimes I do. So I do this really fun thing called creeping. It's like my, it's a really fun job I have. We all should be professional creepers. And if you haven't started, start your job. Okay. Unless you're out meeting people all day face to face, you need to be a professional, cyber creeper. Okay. So when people enter my party, if they have a cute profile picture or something a little amusing that they said, I'm like, yo, let's be friends. Okay. That is how I have met 90% of the reps on my team. I love doing that. I become friends with them. They watch my stories. I stay consistent on social media. And there you go. That's not answering a question. I can't control if they see it or they don't. All I can control is my actions. So I send the message and I pray to God and the Holy Spirits and the leggings people that they see it and then they buy light and tights. That is what I do. And girlfriend,
can I share a tip? Oh, sorry.
No, go ahead.
One thing that I've noticed when I'm prospecting, whether it's for the business or whatever, is sending a second message. And if you've ever sent me a message and I didn't get back to you, chances are I looked at it or my kid did, and then I missed it. So because I know that that's me, I know that a lot of people out there do the same. They maybe see it, but if they didn't see it, if you send a second message, go back to the follow-up. I gave you a couple of scripts, like sample messages to send. When you send if you send a message and you don't get any response, send a second one and say, hey, I'm not sure if you saw my message. I know that Facebook is like super weird. So just wanted to make sure that you didn't miss it. Just wanted to check in with you. Something like that. Like, I know, you know, like, oh, I'm sorry. Maybe you didn't see it. Maybe you saw it. You didn't, like, it depends. And the other one, if a couple of days go by, you can say, blame yourself and say, oh my God, I'm so sorry. I didn't get a chance to follow up with you sooner. I've been super busy. Even though it's not your fault, like you're sitting there for 3 days waiting for them to reply, just say, I'm so sorry, I've been super busy, just wanted to follow up with you. Did you get a chance? We're gonna close the party soon. Did you get a chance to look at the link? Can I help you? Something like that. Like, don't just send one. If one doesn't do it, maybe two or three, it's fine. Be a creeper, like Erica said.
That's awesome. Robin, were there other questions?
Yeah. One of them, gosh, what was the one I was going to mention? Shoot.
I know. I'm trying to look. If you had a question and we didn't answer it, just drop it in the comments.
Oh, but somebody said, do you do your multi-hostess parties for a week or for a month?
I love you and God bless your soul if you do a party for a month. My girl Anna, she's on right now. She told me she did parties for 2 weeks and I thought I was going to die. You guys, I'm in and out fast and furious. Here's the deal. I have a very small attention span. I want to work with busy people. I want to work with people who don't have a lot of time on their hands, because those people are the ones who are spending money and the ones who are doing the thing. I don't want the lurkers. And I know that sounds really awful, but the lurkers sit and they wait and they don't make purchases, and they send you a lot of messages and ask you a lot of questions and then never buy. And those ones are super fun, right? So what I do is I run my parties. I always start them on a Tuesday because I don't want anything wrecking my weekends. So all my hosts get messages on Friday. I say, invite your people over the weekend. You do the work on the weekend. I'm going to be hanging with my family because this is the life I live. Monday, I'm going to be back in your inbox. Tuesday, party kicks off. Close the party out Wednesday night. I want at least two new release days in there. But sometimes if the party's kind of not good, I'm like, Sunday night, we're closing out. Because here's the deal. Create urgency. It's got to be urgent. You've got to make it seem like there's not a lot of time. And here's the deal. Once you close that party on Facebook and stop posting, it still takes like 3 to 4 days for people to get their orders in or have a payday or whatever it is. So get in and out, girlfriend. Like, but people do it all different ways. Again, there's no one right or wrong way. I just don't have the time or patience to have that long of a party. Robin, anything else?
One was, if they don't have, like, if they don't know what a party even is, do you have verbiage for them? I personally would probably invite them to one of my rock star parties that went really well and say, just browse, look through it. Like, could you see yourself doing something like this?
Mm-hmm. I love that. Yep. Perfect. The last party I did, I saw that, you guys, I did it for 5 days because it was the Zaya double rewards. And I knew my hosts were going to take 10 days to put in their order. So I did a 5 day party and it was like the first through the sixth or whatever. Do I do giveaways? Yes, I do gift card giveaways. I always do gift card giveaways because, you guys, that means they're going to come and spend. And that's just how I go and do it, but everybody can do it differently. I usually do two $5 gift cards per host, which probably seems kind of low to a lot of people, but I like to reward the customers, my loyal customers who are in my VIPs. So I might give you a little entry into the door, but once you get into my VIP, that's where I treat you like royalty. How many messages do you send before it stops when you're getting no replies or no reads on messages? I send until I'm blocked or until I'm done. But I know Facebook does like it when you get responses and won't block you as much. So I don't know, maybe take a 5 minute break, go pee, grab a new beer. I don't know. I don't do a lot of discounts, honestly, you guys. I just don't. And everybody does it differently and you totally can. But I really love finding super loyal customers and people who want to buy Zaya because they love the quality. But everybody does it different. I know a lot of reps who are super successful and they offer a lot of discounts. And that's, I do in my VIP. I'm like, come hang out with me in this treasured private group. Yeah. I think that's it, you guys. So I'm going to cut this off for tonight because we're 1 minute over, but I appreciate all of the questions and I hope this helps. So tomorrow night, you guys, we have two more nights of this awesome winter training series and then it's gone. And then you're out on your own having to flop around like a fish out of water. So come join us for the next two nights. Don't miss out. It's Thirsty Thursday tomorrow night. And you're going to hear from some ballers, which I'm actually excited to hear from. I've got to meet some of these ladies. Emily, Josie, and Kim are all going to be talking tomorrow night, anywhere from social media. So if you're like, I don't know what to post, come join Emily. You can learn how to be productive and intentional. You're also going to learn our compensation plan, if you don't already know it, and how to rank advance. So it's going to be elite training. So please, please, please come join us tomorrow night. And we will see you ladies there. Thank you so much for joining us three, and we'll see you later.
Thanks, everybody.